AI is everywhere and everyone is talking about it, but as it turns out, the vast majority of what they're saying is misleading at best, and at worst, an outright deception. While the feature on your smartwatch or your new Copilot PC is called AI, it's not the AI that you're probably thinking of. So we're gonna take a reality hammer to this hype machine and break down what AI can do, what it can't do, and why the tech industry is so eager to slap the AI label on absolutely everything. And guys, this rabbit hole goes way deeper than you think. Okay, predictably it ends at money, but the path to get there, it turns out, is really confusing on purpose, which makes it very interesting. Like this interesting message from our sponsor.
MSI, their Aegis RS2 is a pre-built PC touting some impressive specs, like an Intel Core i7 1400KF, 16 gigs of DDR5 RAM, and a GeForce RTX 4070 Super. Check it out in the description.
The classic definition of AI is probably best illustrated with fictional examples. It's what you see in sci-fi creations like Commander Data, HAL 9000, and GLaDOS. These are computers or machines that demonstrate a capacity for reason, however naive, twisted, or alien it might seem to us meatbags. Now, you'd be forgiven for thinking that that's still the definition of AI. A lot of people seem to think that it is. But in reality, the meaning of words is ever shifting, and we would now refer to these characters as having AGI, or artificial general intelligence. What you're referring to as AI then is in fact narrow AI, or as I've taken to calling it, ANI. ANI is not a general intelligence unto itself, but rather another component of a fully functioning system made useful by specialized algorithms and data processing utilities forming a complete artificial intelligence system. Didn't think I could make that point in the style of Richard Stallman's famous interjection? Well, I could, haha, but I also didn't have to. That previous paragraph was actually written by GPT-4 Omni, and this is exactly the sort of thing that modern AI does very well. And that's because most of the time when we hear the term AI, we're actually referring to machine learning, a subset of AI involving algorithms that can analyze patterns in data. They get trained on things like text, multimedia, or even just raw number outputs. And using this training data, they identify patterns through statistical probability. They can be further trained through reinforcement learning then by rewarding correct outputs and punishing incorrect outputs, kind of like training a hamster. The results allow these algorithms to summarize, predict, or even generate something seemingly new. And in many cases, they are so impressive that a good machine learning system can be indistinguishable from classic AI or AGI. Well then, Linus, if it looks like an AI and it quacks like an AI, what's the difference? Well, artificial narrow intelligence is limited to specialized tasks. GPT-4 Omni, specifically, is a large language model, which means that it is trained to understand and generate natural language, like the words I'm speaking now. It's basically an autocomplete on steroids. What sets it apart from your phone's keyboard, though, is that it can also process information based on patterns that are learned during training, including definitions, mathematical formula, and so on and so forth. That makes it capable of generating unique output that wasn't part of its training data. GPT has traditionally been incapable of image, video, or audio generation. There are other types of generative models, like Sora, Suno, or DALL-E, that feature their own specific talents, but most of them are incapable of operating outside of their specific niche, and all of them are limited by their training data in a similar manner. And because they are limited by their training data, in many cases, the answers that they give resemble their training data, which, if you're an artist or a photographer and your work gets added to a model, it's probably not your idea of fair use, much less a good time. Worse, when generative models are faced with a concept that they don't understand, or they simply run out of tokens, they can begin to hallucinate. That is to say, they just make things up as they go, which is why sometimes you get eldritch abominations like these. With that said, these limitations don't mean that machine learning AI is a dead end. It's been deployed very effectively for diagnosing diseases and in other highly complex scenarios where the data is dense and the conclusions require interpretation. These specialized models are extremely useful. They're just also extremely not new. Simple neural networks have been in use for decades for things ranging from handwriting recognition to web traffic analysis. And yes, even video game AI.
So these are not scripted sequences. The AI is determining when your allies choose to advance and how to best help you out in combat.
And chatbots. The main difference is that they run much faster on modern hardware. If I had to distill down what artificial narrow intelligence really means then, I would say it's like having 1,000 monkeys at 1,000 typewriters with 1,000 pieces of reference material for what the outputs are supposed to look like. With enough trial and error then, they do arrive at a point where they're likely to spit out a correct or at least correct enough solution. Then we take all those monkeys and we take a snapshot of the model's state and we start feeding it inputs for both fun and profit. What ANI is to a brain then is kind of what a single app is to a computer. It's a building block, it's something your brain is capable of, but it's just one of its many, many functions. Shifting gears a bit then, what would artificial general intelligence look like? Well, it would need to be able to handle everything we've talked about so far, just like your brain can take some past experiences and turn them into a new creation, but again, like your own brain, it would need to be able to run many of these models concurrently and continuously train and iterate on them rather than relying on fixed snapshots. Only then would an AGI have the ability to truly learn and adapt to new things, bringing it closer to that classical definition of AI and really blur the lines between machine learning and machine consciousness. The problem is, even if we had software that sophisticated, we are nowhere close to being able to run an AGI, even on a modern supercomputer, let alone on your AI smartphone. But, all right, Linus, you still haven't explained why any of this is even a problem. I mean, free-range meat is just marketing bollocks too, so who cares? Well, truthfully, in most cases, I don't. I mean, Cooler Master's AI thermal paste snafu, I was never bothered by it because I never expected my paste to be sentient anyway. But there are situations where this kind of marketing can have an impact on user safety and therefore does matter. Let's talk about Tesla. Mr. Musk has said, among other things, that any vehicle from 2019 onward will be able to reach full autonomy. And he's certainly put out some impressive demos, both canned and even in the form of public beta software that you really can use. And that's really cool, but unfortunately, it isn't much more than that. You see, to operate a vehicle safely, it's not enough to be trained with images of painted lines and traffic cones, stop signs, pedestrians, vehicle telemetry data. It's not even enough to be trained to predict the likely maneuvers of nearby vehicles and life forms. On the road, anything can happen. And by definition, by its very definition, ANI is not capable of handling an edge case that it has never seen before. Even if it was, by the way, I have some really bad news for you Tesla owners out there. Hardware 3.0 has about 144 TOPS, or trillion operations per second worth of processing power. For context, Windows 11 Recall, a feature that does little more than take screenshots and analyze your PC usage for search, asks for 40 TOPS. Now, to be clear, TOPS is not a be-all, end-all measure of performance, and there is no way that Microsoft has optimized the code for Recall nearly as much as Tesla has for full self-driving. But this should still illustrate the point that Tesla either did or should have known that a vehicle with the AI capabilities of a family of iPhone 15 Pro users would never achieve that kind of real-time contextual awareness that's required for complex situations like operating a motor vehicle, and they misrepresented its capabilities in order to sell more software that was never going to leave beta. That is going to be a doozy of a class action. And it's a common story that has led to this current mess where fuzzy definitions and impossible promises have turned AI into this meaningless buzzword like all the rest of them. All of them refer to legitimate, useful technologies, some of which have really come to fruition. but their meanings have become diluted with overuse, and it means that when computer cognition finally happens, we're gonna have to call it something completely different in order to differentiate it from all of the marketing wank. On the subject of marketing, calling ANI AI wasn't an accident. The people behind that marketing know what you think AI means. They know that the promise and the mystique behind the term is tantalizing, and they know you'll click on an article that is interviewing an AI expert who discusses how dangerous or already alive it is. They want you to buy into their hype. They want you to buy into their stocks. What we have now, though, really, are decent summarization engines and lukewarm guessing machines that are tuned for working with different types of media. They can't reason. And anyone who's seen ChatGPT get something ridiculously, confidently wrong can attest to that. And they also can't understand why they get these things wrong, which means they can't learn or improve on their own, even if you explicitly tell them. They also have a finite number of things that they can remember, called tokens, which limit their ability to maintain a train of thought for very long. Anyone who's tried to get ChatGPT to write a novel or even a moderately complex Python script can probably attest to that. Of course, as time goes on, some of these limitations will begin to lift, and these ANI models will start to look more and more like AGI to the layperson. I mean, just ask the guy who had Bing fall in love with him. But at the end of the day, it's still the same thing as it's always been. To paraphrase a paper co-written by Emily Bender and Alexander Koller, it's a hyper-intelligent octopus that is observing and learning the patterns that are expected of communication and repeating them back more accurately over time. So when faced with a novel situation, like a bear attack, that octopus has no hope of being able to guide you on how to defend yourself with the materials you have on hand. It has no concept of bear or stick. Only what words most closely match the pattern that it has previously observed. To further illustrate this, if you haven't tried it before, try to craft a prompt that coaxes Stable Diffusion to spit out something very specific. It turns out it's pretty challenging, and when it finally does it, it's generally composed of a mosaic of shapes and patterns from its training model that best match the keywords. That sounds overly simplified, but that's because it is, in essence, what it's doing. It takes the keywords from your prompt and starts compositing, filling in the image until it hits, for example, a certain percentage of computer and desk. And it does this without any context. So if you asked it to show you a computer, would it show you a desktop PC, a laptop, a server rack, and for that matter, from what era? The answer is often simply yes, because it lacks the context behind what computer means to you. And it can't always even form a coherent depiction, even in the same image. So then, Linus, just don't worry about it and wait till AGI shows up and you don't have to bother with online dating anymore? Well, not quite. As generative ANI models learn to create works that are closer and closer to our expectations, and to finally understand how many fingers and teeth humans normally have, we're gonna start to find it more and more difficult to distinguish their output from real photographs or artwork or other people, ushering in an era of unprecedented distrust. And the bad news is that the folks in charge of helping us deal with the consequences of all of this have a lot less funding than the ones who are trying to sell it to us. So be safe out there and safely check out our sponsor.
Manscaped. If you're looking for a way to quickly take care of your more delicate parts, Manscaped is on the case with their Performance Package 5.0 Ultra. It includes the Lawnmower 5.0 Ultra to trim the grass, as well as the Weed Whacker 2.0 for your ears and nose, so it doesn't feel like you're always tickling yourself. You'll even get their Crop Soother, made with shea butter and cocoa seed butter, designed to pamper your delicate areas with essential moisture and soothing relief. And for an added layer of freshness, give your package a royal treatment with their Crop Preserver to keep the funk at bay. Check out the Performance Package 5.0 Ultra at manscaped.com/techtips and use code techtips for 20% off and free shipping.
If you guys enjoyed this video and you're looking for some more debunking spelunking, maybe check out our recent video on PC speed up tools to see if they really do what they say they do.